Found most of the CMU touching, but I still get this version of the unit. And one of the worst things that you cannot do is use the name of the dynamic. So, what does ECL do now? So now ECL is a library. It's a library of C code, which has the same components. It has a supporting library made of a bunch of functions to create and manipulate these objects. It has an interpreter, and it has a subset of the common Lisp standard, which has been compiled from Lisp to C. So all this is packed together into a library that anybody can use from the scratch. I will show you at the end of the talk. It's done in a way, in a safe way. So this environment is isolated from your C program by providing, for instance, with a memory manager that you can use in your C program, which is a more important part of the graphics collector. So the goals of this project are many. The main one is portability. We want to use this implementation in as many operating systems as possible. How we do it? We do it by writing the code so that it uses the least power dependencies. In our case, it proves that the RC command and CC provides most of everything that you need. Right now, ECL runs on these platforms, and it's quite power dependent. There are some caveats. The first one is that due to the way to represent objects, we need the clean pointer to get conversion, so that any pointer can be converted to an integer and compact. It's funny because if you read the ACC standard, this is not supported by the language. So, it's all compilers that work with it. And also, the ECL implementation combines the Lisp function to C functions, which can receive directly the arguments in the stack. So, it's like using C calling conversions. This is not standard because you can call this function with any number of arguments that you want. And finally, there is an element which we can tell you, it's the garbage collector. We need a garbage collector for this. And this is the only non-standard component we need. So we have used one garbage collector, which is used by a larger community. We don't have to maintain it. We don't have to care the dependency of the hardware. It's quite portable already. The second goal is to comply with the original ECL implementation by UCP Atari was complying with common Lisp, the language second part. And it was pretty good. So I mean, the compliance was perfect. But if you try to run ECL code, then you find out some glitches. For instance, simple macros and structuring were not implemented in the old implementation of ASI common Lisp. We had to work this out. And now ECL is status that is quite ASCII standard. So you can, if you manage to submit something, you can drag it from anywhere else. For instance, we needed a loop, two macro, and we simply grab the one from CMCL, which is based on symbolics, and it works. So you simply take it, run it, and it's working. Some caveats also, that some things which are not perfect, is the format of the routine is not completely, not 100% standard. Implemented in C, the code is very old and it will take some time to revise it and update it. There is no pretty reason, but once more, if somebody needs it, you can take it from C or C or some other place. And the tag hierarchy is, I think it's okay, but the routines are not very clean. And the integration between clause and zeros and the core of the implementation is not very nice. The third goal and probably the most important one is we want the self-boot tabbing implementation. That means I take my tab file, I compile it, and this produces an interpreter, and this interpreter is capable of compiling the rest of the code. The reason why we want this is that this source code that should be portable to any machine, to any environment. So I can take this interpreter, which is based on NCC, and I can take it back in production, I can compile it, and then this interpreter, they can compile the rest of this code to NCC, and then you get the portable chain. With CMU-CL, for instance, you need an existing CMU-CL implementation to compile some of the implementation in another platform. This is quite big. But the reasons are different. study that. Maybe it's not an expert in commodities. And another is not an expert in writing compilers. So if I make a mistake and I'm using a, so I use the same implementation to bootstrap itself and then replace the old implementation with a new one and I make a mistake, then this mistake is in the box. So it's propagates and it's very difficult to fix. And the idea is that anyone who plays with the implementation should be able to extend it and to replace it and improve it. And I think it's the safest way. Another goal is that we want ECM to be shipped as a library. We want it to be used like Guile or like Python or like any other extension language. So people simply take it, put it in an application and define it works. And then you cannot only use the library, you can also use the development environment, the top level. You can use it to solve more or less the same parameter to what it comes yesterday afternoon. You have a platform, you embed it into your program, and you find it works, and then use it for anything else. So CL as an extension language, deliver standalone application. This can be done right now. So you can use CL in any CL++ application. And the other thing is that we want to keep this CL as small as possible. So sometimes we sacrifice speed for size. Why? Because people normally approach an implementation and it takes half an hour to decide whether it's nice or not. And in this half an hour, what they want to see is if that's what they want, what they want, then it's large. If it's too large, then they want to decide. But the way this is something more or less of what I didn't know about commodities. So a little bit about the details of the implementation, just in case you want to play with it. There is a fundamental component, the garbage collector. We are using the one batch garbage collector. There are several reasons for using it. The first one is that it's conservative. It's makes it easier to program when you don't have to relocate data from one place to another. The second one is that it can handle large amounts of memory nicely, no problems. The ECL implementation still has an old garbage collector, which is limited to 16 megabytes. But the main point is it has good support for C and C++ programming. So this memory this library is shipped with this year, and the C program may simply replace the malloc with the malloc to from this library, and the same program works. And at the same time, you get support for commodities. But the bottom line is that the design is made so that you don't need to use this garbage collector if you have the better one. You find a better replacement. Stupid things is that we have only 20 media drinkers, which I think is not in charge. We want to work on two things. The first one is to extend the implementation to work on the system with 64 bits per word, not 64. This is mostly that. Just a matter of taking the code and compiling it in some other machine. And we also would like to use not only C characters, 255 characters, but white characters. We also implemented using new library, which is portable, it's available everywhere. The core library is a library that provides you with routines to build and manipulate these objects. It's quite complete. Has things like taking a C string and converting it to a object, has an evaluator. You can work with the strings, more or less if you work with them in common list. The ultimate goal is to provide one C function for every list function. So people already get familiar with this interface and then they can switch to common list. This is what I found out very nice from MC scheme. This scheme has a wonderful set of wonderful libraries, you can embed very easily MC scheme into your C program. And then you find that it's very nice to work with scheme and then you drop the C program. So as I told you, the library is quite complete and comes with implementation to simulate almost all the control structures. But still needs work. For instance, we have to avoid name caching, so we have to protect all names with some prefix, so we have to find out which functions are missing. Since support is not very good at the moment, and the most difficult part would be to implement to help C programmers to take advantage of blocks in C code. the interpreter. This is the main change of this implementation with respect to the other ones. So I didn't like personally this working and Marcos Pack at runtime. So what they did was to implement the bytecode compiler. You have your dispatch on and it's translated to a virtual machine. The virtual machine is implemented, so it's like a low level implementation of commodities with calling within some leaves and conditionals. There are 26 instructions for manipulating variables, 14 instructions for usual code branches, and then there are 10 instructions which simulate this five level instructions. This makes it very easy to write the bytecode interpreter. And it actually, for this process, was many syntaxes were architected at compile time. The algorithm is pretty stupid, so the compiler is not very clever, doesn't do many optimization, but it works quite well. So if you compare interpreted code, it's between the speed of code C and CMU. CMU is an order of magnitude worse than PCL. But at the same time, compiled code is better in C. When you compile the right code in C, you get very good optimizations. So, things to be done. There is no static debugger yet. It can be done. It's just a matter of time. There's no development environment. There are things like dependency of macros. You might modify a macro if you want to find it. You don't have to change and update it. This was discussed in the endcode in the last week. We can also implement like a source code stacking. Remember where the function comes from, where it's the sort of back information, and so on. As I told you, the implementation has to come with the compiler. The compiler compiles this to C. More or less the loop of the function is like this. So it happens from the list name, you get the macro name, which you can use as a library. This has to be worked out so that it's not good. So have you looking? Basically, all the functional passes, all the parameters are passed in the C stack. And the output of the function is the first value of this evaluation. Right now, limitations is that you can use up to 64 required arguments, but you can pass any number of keyboard and optional arguments using not the C stack, but an auxiliary stack. But as you see here, this is quite transparent for the C programmer. You simply have to declare your required arguments and declares a pointer and initialize it. And this pointer is going to provide you with all the optional and keyboard arguments. And there are things for processing keyboard arguments as well. You can output one value. The convention is that you output the first value of the function. And if you want to output more than one value, you have to ensure you expect to do so. This means that function can be used by a C programmer directly. It simply has to provide the arguments and then get the outputs. So at the end, we will be able to provide one function for every one C function for every composition function and import it. The object files, so each piece of file is translated to a single object file, which has a piece of code. So first, it has a textual representation of the data that it needs. This data is processed at the runtime. It's converted into list objects. And this is stored in an array which can be accessed by the rest of the code. This makes it very easy to have garbage collection and to use read alerts. These object files can be either converted into a dynamically loadable library that you can load at runtime, or you can convert it into a statically loadable library that you can invite into your C program. And by using the VLOOKFRAME function, which is a function for loading dynamically linked libraries, we got rid of this dependency of this concept of list image and dumping and so on, things to be done. Well, first we want to get rid of this argument, which measures the number of arguments that the function gets, so that the compiled function looks more C-like. So you simply pass the arguments and take the output. The library names, so these names that you see here are designed so that the C programmers do not use this function. So they look at the purpose, but we want to get rid of this. So the C programmer can call directly C functions, list functions. And so ECL comes with the void functions interface. You can compile a piece of list file, and then you get access to the library, C library. That's why I think this was a nice one, but it's bad audio, it has to be improved, so it's quite new. The biggest catch that I found with using libraries is that in most operating systems you cannot load two libraries with the same thing. So it means you compile this file, then you get the library, a DLL, and then you load it. And then you modify this source file, and then you want to load it again, but the Unix file thinks it's the same library and it doesn't load. So it's working for us, we have to find a nice way to handle a previously loaded compiled file. Startup, but see, it doesn't prevent you from using the environment right now. Work in progress, as I told you, there is no restriction on having 64 required arguments. This restriction is arbitrary, it's just a matter of weeks to get rid of it, and then we get the funny thing, which the next thing, which is that we can do structure object with more. A software object, because if you remember, when you make a structure, you can make a constructor. And the number of arguments of this constructor is now restricted to be 64. It's proved to be a stopper for porting CLIs. The word of port is almost done. We have all the routine for doing with sockets and so on. And we really have to finish this stupid thing. Threads, the Coco model for the secondary implementation of threads. It's not the type of thread that Roger Roman talked about yesterday, but it's a userless thread, which means that you have code that is interacting your programs every now and then, and it's sharing the time between different pieces of disk. So we still have to rescue this implementation with all the modifications that I made to the code, and it doesn't work anymore. So it's a matter of some data also to recover it. And then this code can be reduced to get some more process like threads where you can let the operating system to the scale. Fell out with Roger Common 5 years ago. Safe evaluation. So there are some projects which are considered easier for evaluating up right now. There are many projects. So this, I think it was a Lego who once ago using one main code. People heard about this view being used in also in abuse, another game. And so they think that it would be nice to have a list of interpreters in the game just because somebody else has used it. So this has affected a number of people, and there are some stoppers. The main one is that you need a safe environment. So you need that if somebody passes you some code and you execute it, and this code does something nasty, it's not going to break your program. So you need a way to reinitialize your system. This is something that the most common is implementation do not provide. It's a restart implementation for scratch. We have to start in your program. So there's a lot of work to do to figure out what has to be protected, what has not to be protected. And also usability. So I mean, I'm doing this project for myself, but I would like people to use it. The device that the way I implement it is the way I like to use it. But if you find this program is not, you should doing something that should be done some other way. The best thing is to say it, and then this can be done. For instance, if you think you have heard about the new common list, no. GNOME, for instance, is a graphical environment which provides lots of libraries. And the interface from library to library and the number of libraries you have to link to your program is changing from revision to revision. And somebody asked me, for an easy way to link the ECL to the C programs. Right now we have the program, which is ECL config, which gives you all the tasks you need to compile and link your application with ECL. Here I show you a very stupid demo where we are going to make a listener. It's a C program. So first you have to initialize the library. Optionally you can pass it the arguments and will pass to the program so that the library can get some information about the environment. Then we write down a prompt with a format routine. We read some code, so we read some object, this object, using the read routine, just like in this. We evaluate this routine in a safe environment, meaning if the routine causes an error, this error is going to be caught, and then this output value is going to be output. So in this case, this error is the arrow is a keyword. And then we output the output of the re-evaluation. And you simply have to compile it. So you see here the ECL complete fragment. It's asking you that I flash for compiling the program and the library. And then you can run it. And then you can execute it. And then you can do some nasty things, and then nothing happens. Okay? Yes, the last demo is, let's see if it works. So this is, I think it's the cutest piece problem we have served ever seen. So this is a game, actually. It's in working progress, it's called Unicode, it's done by Unicode, and you can find it in source code. It's a map-based game with some graphical environments from Crystal Space, some of it, and Crystal Space. And then, so he used it to provide an evaluator for commodities. Okay, so. I don't know. You can debug your code. The good thing is that the translated C code is quite beautiful story. So you can understand what's going on. It's quite easy if you want to think about it.
So when, if I had a file of Lisp code and there were like 20 functions in there, if I compile a file using ECL, it creates a single DLL, is that right?
Yes.
So it converts it to C, then it compiles to C directly and into a DLL. So there's no usage of bytecode, or is there?
There is no usage of bytecode.
Okay.
Bytecode is only used when you load source code. When you load the Lisp code?
When you interpret it.
Yes. Actually, there is no, because I didn't find it useful, there is no facility to save bytecode that's passing by, like C Lisp does. But there's something that also can be done. The bytecode compiler is quite fast, so it's pretty easy to load as many source files as you want.
Yeah, you mentioned that compile code in C Lisp is still at ECL. Have you done any benchmarks on that?
Yes, we have the benchmarks in the web pages. Like, of course, it's faster than bytecode in ECL, but it's slower than compiled this code in ECL. So, if you want to think about it, if you think about interpreted code, then C Lisp is the winner. Then it's ECL, and then it's CMU.CL. If you think about compiled code, then it's CMU.CL, the best implementation, and it's ECL, and then and it's C Lisp. But, yes.
Can you write your URL to your project page for this? Can we read more about this later?
So that's where I have to
I wanted to learn more about the project. Do you have a web page or something?
Yes, it's only run out of my page.
So I wanted to write on the board because it's on the chart there.
You do a web search on ECL.
Again, one more question about debugging. If I were to debug, if I deliver, if I deliver something using ECL, and I tell GCC, maximum debug class, and now I'm debugging the code, since it's one kind of monolithic image, so when I'm in GDB and I'm stepping through the lines of C code, that C code that I'm looking at are the lines of, are the C generated code from ECL, is that right?
Yes. Yes, but there, so in the code you see hints about where this comes from and which function is related to this C code. So you can really pretty much understand what is going on. And there are also many codes in the C library which has readable things like read and format and so on. So the web page is. Thank you.